Morning. Welcome to our service of worship. Whether you are with us in person, joining us live on Zoom, or watching several days from now, we are glad you are here. We extend a special welcome to our visitors. For those in person, please use the time before worship to fill in the friendship pad in your pew. Today, Growing Connections will take place in the parlor. Jenny Dane, our guest speaker, will talk about AdvoCap and Head Start. She will tell us about the Head Start program and how it has evolved and how it prepares children to be successful in elementary school. Sunday School for All Children will meet in classrooms off the gathering area at 10:20 a.m. Our fellowship time will take place in the gathering room. We are showing Thanksgiving videos from 2020 as a reminder of what we have been thankful for in our past. In the bulletin, you will find an order form for poinsettias. Please note that the deadline to order is December 3rd. You can place your order and payment in the offering plate or drop it off in the office. Veterans Day was yesterday, and we would like to express thanks for all who have and are serving our country. If you would please stand. Thank you. Cribbage will meet this coming Friday at 7 p.m. in the Fellowship Hall. Newcomers are welcome. Next week, Sunday, during the fellowship time, we'll have an intergenerational activity around gratitude and generosity. There will be opportunities to make cards for the Thanksgiving bags and to sign Thanksgiving cards for people on our care list. Now I would like to invite Nancy Hilbert from the Loving Team to come forward and share information about Night of Silence.
Morning. Friday, December 8th through Sunday, December 10th, the Fondlac High School Music Department gives our community a wonderful Christmas program, Night of Silence. We have high school students from our church family performing in the Night of Silence. Tomorrow, tickets go on sale. The Loving Team will reserve a block of seats for members. All seats are reserved seating for $10 each. If you are interested in going with our church group, please go to the Welcome Center and sign up. And I'm going to add something else too. The first time I went to Night of Silence, I had no clue what silence was. Were we going to go there and be silent the whole time or what? And I was, to my surprise, it wasn't a night of silence. It was beautiful Christmas music. But the silence comes because you don't clap between the performances. And it's a really beautiful Christmas program. Thank you.
Now let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship. Please stand for the call to worship. Welcome to God's house, a place of faith. Here you will find nourishment and hope. Here you will find rest from your struggles.
That we may leave this holy house in faith and return to our homes, encouraged and challenged to be your people. Amen.
God of all times and of all places, you invite us to worship you through the beauty of the world around us, and in every experience of joy and love you give us. Open our hearts now to praise you for all these gifts. Fill our hearts to overflowing with gratitude, so that rivers of love pour out from us to everyone we meet. Bless our worship in spirit, in the truth, and help us to hear your voice speaking to us today and every day. Amen.
Lies, Lord of all truth.
God's law is right and just, offering us wisdom and enlightenment. We ignore the importance of God's law in our lives and persist in our own ways. In humility, let us confess our sins. God of the law and the prophets, we do not want to admit all the commandments that we have broken. We worship idols and whom success and power. We do not use your name to justify whatever we do. We do not honor each other, covet, lie, we wish evil upon others. Our sins are too many to name. Forgive us, speak to us, and we will listen, remembering that you are our freedom and deliverer. Please take a moment for silent confession.
Do not be afraid. God loves us with an everlasting love. God's grace is unending. Siblings in Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God for such graciousness. And now we want to share the peace of Christ. The peace of Christ be with you.
Thank you.
Today's scripture lesson comes from Colossians 3, 15 through 17, and it's page 201 in the Pew Bible. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him.
I'd like to invite the children to come forward. Good morning. So, did any of you go trick-or-treating a little while ago? Yeah, a couple weeks ago. And when someone gave you a piece of candy, what did you say? Oh, you said thank you, right? When someone does something nice for you, what do you say? Oh, you say you're welcome when someone says thank you to you, and you say thank you. If someone helps you do something, you say thank you. We do, when we say thank you, when we're grateful for something that someone's done for us or given to us. So guess what? You know who we don't say thank you to very much? Usually the people who love us the most. Do you say thank you to your moms and dads very often? When they wash your clothes or make your dinner, you say thank you? Awesome. I'm sure they're very happy. One of the people that loves us the most is God. And God has given us so many things. And is there a way that we could say thank you? How do we say thank you to God? What do we do? We tell people about God. We tell people about the things that God has given to all of us, right? We praise God. We sing songs like we've just sang. We say prayers to God. We learn more about God. We tell people about God. And we do that every single day. Anybody here ever forget to do that? That kind of happens, doesn't it? It does. So I was thinking, when I was thinking about this, what if tomorrow, when you wake up, I want grown-ups to think about this too. What if tomorrow, when you wake up, the only things that you have are the things that you said thank you to for God yesterday? Wow. God is so wonderful to us each and every day. And we do say prayers when we have dinner, maybe, when you have a meal, when you eat food, when you go to bed at night. But we can also praise God all throughout the day. When you see, and that happens here at nighttime, we have the best sunsets here at church. Right in the back. If you look in the fellowship hall windows, out the back windows in the evening, the best sunsets. I highly recommend them. And whenever anybody's here, they look out the windows and they say, oh, what a beautiful sunset. Right? That's appreciating God's creation in your heart. And when we have our grateful hearts, when we are so appreciative of all the things that God has given us, that's that grateful heart that Miss Sara just talked about in that scripture. So we're getting close to Thanksgiving, when we all want to talk about what we're grateful and thankful for. And it's great that we spend a day and we think about that. But each and every day, I want you to remember to thank God for all of the gifts that God's given us, and find ways in which you can thank God for that and telling other people. So let's take a little time right now. And let's thank God for some of those things. When I say some of those words out loud, I want you to think in your heart what you're so grateful to God for giving to you. Let's pray. Loving and gracious God, we thank you for the gifts that you give to us each and every day. We thank you for the people that you put into our lives that help us learn more about you and more about your love. We thank you for the people that give us your love each day.
We know that sometimes we forget to appreciate all of those gifts. We forget to say thank you. We ask that you would open up our hearts to find ways to share the love that you give to us, to everyone that we meet. Help us to let them know that that love is for them, that they are loved by God, just as we are loved by God. We pray all of these things in Jesus' name, and all God's children said, Amen.
Well, good morning again. My name is Joanne Marchionda, and I am part of the worship team, and we are leading worship today. And what a nice segue with our scripture and what Jennifer had to say to everyone today, because our title of the sermon that we want to share with you is Intentional Thanksgiving. Okay? I want you to kind of think about that for a minute. Being thankful involves feeling and expressing appreciation for people and things in your life. Okay, let that sink in a minute. Being thankful involves feeling and expressing appreciation for people and things in your life. When you're asked, what are you thankful for? Well, it's easy to come up with the cliches, right? My health and my family, and those kind of things. And you really might, you mean it, but those aren't the meat and potatoes or getting down to just the cliche, the level surface of what are we really thankful for? And in order for you, I think, to be really thankful for something, you have to kind of develop a lifestyle. You kind of have to develop this lifestyle of actually living and being thankful. It's easy to go around the table and say, I'm thankful for this. Whew, my turn's done. Okay, so we're trying to focus a little bit more on how can we live in a lifestyle that actually is being thankful. Well, to do that, you're going to have to need to slow down. And that's so hard for a lot of us here. I was just talking with Cheryl, and her weekend, and she told me everything that they packed in their weekend. They're not even done yet, and I'm exhausted hearing it. But they're busy, busy people. Your families are busy, and you need to just try to mentally really focus and remember that you need to slow down. And then when you slow down, you need to intentionally to look at and focus on all aspects of your life. Well, here's what intent means, the definition that I chose. There's plenty. It's a state of mind with which an act is done. It's with purpose. You have intent to do something. It's in your mind. It's on your mind. You're going to say it. You're going to express it. And hopefully you're going to have an activity to really show you're thankful, and it's with purpose. What a great example. This is unbelievable. Thank you everybody for this food drive. This was intentional because we had you focus on your need. What needs do we really need to survive or live? And what need, my Diet Coke, somebody else's mocha latte, frappy, hoopy poopy. Those things are what we also brought that really aren't what we need to survive. But this surpasses what I thought would happen today. So worship team and everyone, thank you for this. This was intentional. And when your intent and you have that purpose, it's a success. So what I'm talking about with is if you really are intentional to look at and focus at all aspects of your life. That's hard to do, it takes time. And that's why we need to slow down and really focus on the areas of work. Not can I do better, not that, but the area where you work. Do you thank your coworker? Do you thank the person who dumps your garbage cans or cleans out the coffee pot? To do that, you'd have to be focused, have that purpose, be mindful, and have intention to do that. That's what we want you to look at and try to do at home.
to have intent and purpose when you are thankful and thankful for someone or something. At play, if you're on the recess, out at recess, are you thankful when your friend has to give you boost up onto the bars? Are you thankful if that little zip line on the playground makes it all the way? Okay, those kind of things, even when you're playing, we have to have mindful intention, focus with it. Community, we're pitching into our community. Do we make a note on the calendar to have purpose and remember, oh yeah, we're having this in the community, the night of silence. I really should sign up because it's a great, great night to be thankful for beautiful young voices and the beautiful Performing Arts Center and the director. To think of your church, with what intent do you come here and be thankful and show your thankfulness? Have you ever tried liturgy, being a liturgist? Have you ever tried being a cantor? Woo, I don't know. Maybe you have to go through Kris, I'm not sure. But have you ever tried something like that? Oh, I could maybe usher. Or, oh shoot, I forgot, it's the month I usually usher. I didn't sign up. That intent didn't pop up. So we're trying to focus on that today, and your family as well, to be thankful and intentionally make a purpose to say thank you, show your gratitude toward them. Because, you know, when you really take stock, there's really so, so much to be thankful for. The areas may be so specific, like people in your life, a job, to pay the bills, to thank someone who waited on you, the food that you eat, a place to live, someone who gave you a compliment, or just being out in nature, hearing beautiful sounds and fresh fall air. I think that we've had a great couple weekends to do that. A little brisk or a little wind, but man, what a fall. And the possibilities of what we're thankful for can go on and on and on. But I'm going to let my other teammates kind of delve a little bit deeper in intentional Thanksgiving.
Hello, my name is Kristina Arellano. When I heard the worship team was going to do a service focusing on thankfulness, I immediately knew I wanted to share my story. Many of you know my family and I recently went through some really difficult crises. In August of 2018, we were in a devastating car accident that totaled our car and sent me into 16 months of physical therapy. I was in so much pain, I could barely walk. For almost a year, I could barely practice piano. I went from practicing piano 8 to 10 hours a week to 1 hour a week. For a year and a half, I could barely lift my violin for more than a few minutes each day. Less than a month after the car accident, our second car died on the highway. So we went from 2 cars to 0 cars in less than a month. 5 months after the car accident, my 13-year-old niece was diagnosed with brain cancer. She died 7 months later. The thing that made her death extra devastating is that she was in the passenger seat next to me during the car accident. And when the pickup truck impacted us, I watched her body flail around, and I thought, she's going to be crippled for life. But miraculously, we all survived. And while she was sore for quite a while, I was so grateful I was the one who was seriously injured and not her. But 1 year later, she died. A few months after her death, I woke up one morning and couldn't hear out of my left ear. Overnight, a viral infection attacked the nerve in my ear. I instantly lost half of the hearing in my left ear. You can imagine that as a professional musician, this was a catastrophic blow. And then on top of this, I watched my stepdad die, and a week later, COVID shut down Wisconsin. I was such an emotional wreck that I was grateful for the isolation of COVID, because I didn't want anyone to know how bad I really was. I was basically drowning. So today I'm going to share 4 tips of how I moved from a state of devastation to a mindset of gratitude. Tip number 1, I needed to grieve, but also set healthy boundaries. Sometimes our emotions are so strong, they become all-consuming. My counselor suggested that I schedule my grieving. So I'll say that again. I actually dedicated time in my weekly schedule to grieve. It started as an hour or two a day and slowly morphed into about once a week. During my grieving sessions, I allowed myself to feel everything I could handle. I didn't judge my feelings. I just let them happen. By allowing these moments, I was able to release a lot of emotion and then get back to doing whatever it was I needed to accomplish. Again, the first tip is set healthy boundaries. Tip number 2, find a creative outlet or something that keeps your mind engaged. When you feel like you have little control over your emotions, fill your mind with something to keep it occupied. For me, I got into video editing. Music was such a devastating topic at the time. There were no songs, no melodies that could express how I felt. So I poured myself into creating videos. It became both a mental distraction and my therapy. Sometimes my videos explored my feelings, and sometimes they were projects for our church or people in the community. The main thing is, when your mind starts to wander to the dark side, give it something else to focus on. Again, find a creative outlet or something that keeps your mind engaged. Tip number 3, gratitude is a choice. At my worst, I felt no sense of gratitude whatsoever. However, I knew that if my mind stayed in darkness, I would turn into a bitter, ugly person. I did not want to become that person. So every day at dinner time during COVID, Pedro and I started a new habit. Each day, we shared the favorite part of our day. What was one thing that brought us happiness that day? It helped us remember that despite all appearances, the world was still full of beauty. It is important to not only think about the good things in your life, but also to share those experiences with others. Again, gratitude is a choice, and we need to share that gratitude with others. My final tip, we see what we look for. Aaron at simplepurposefulliving.com says, there is only so much room in our heart. If we look for bad news and negativity, we will find it. We will fill our hearts with despair and bitterness. But if we choose to focus on the candle in the dark room, if we choose to focus on the light, we will find it. Focusing on the light does not make the negative things disappear, but it changes how they impact our future. As a result of my experiences, I learned new hobbies, video editing and graphic arts, and I became a significantly better composer. I began pouring my grief into my music, giving it a new depth. I used to be somewhat timid, but now I have a considerably stronger backbone. Again, we see what we look for. Do I hate that my niece is gone? Yes. Do I hate that my hearing is permanently gone? Yes. Do I still struggle? Yes. Do I still have to remind myself to practice gratitude? Yes. Practicing gratitude will be a lifelong pursuit. I'm so grateful that a friend said to me, "Gratitude is a choice. We choose to be grateful." Choosing to be grateful has basically given me my life back. Thank you.
Good morning. Expressions of thankfulness. Even though thankfulness is a noun, its meaning encompasses much more than simply identifying the things you are thankful for. Thankfulness also involves action. So how do you show gratitude? Verbalize it. Keeping your thankful thoughts to yourself is like buying a present for someone and never giving it. If you are generous with your genuine words of appreciation, you'll be surprised by how good it makes you feel and how well it is received. And try to go beyond the simple thank you. Instead, be specific about what they've done that you're thankful for. For example, rather than simply thanking a veteran for his or her service, tell them how much it means to you that they put their life on the line to defend our freedom. Take time to engage with them, or tell your partner something concrete that you appreciate about them and how it makes you feel. Or thank God for his beautiful creation while you're enjoying it. That's gratitude in action and builds goodwill. Show it. Go even further, try doing something to show your gratitude. Send a card for no reason than to express your appreciation for an everyday thing someone does to make your life better. This is especially impactful for those that often go unrecognized, such as the custodian, the postman, the bank clerk, the grocery stacker, the garbage collector, your state representative, even your boss. Look around at all those who serve in you in various ways. You'll have plenty of people to thank. Other ways to show your gratitude can include buying a gift card, paying for coffee, writing a letter of recognition to someone's boss, leaving a good review, even an extra tip with an encouraging note, or giving a plate of cookies.
So I'm Cheryl Clarenbach, and I'm a member of the worship team also. Kristina told us that gratitude is a choice, and Alisha explained ways that we can express that gratitude. And a final way we can express that gratitude is by serving others. So if you can identify others who struggle with life issues that you don't have, your thankfulness quotient will rise significantly. I'm a math teacher, I had to throw a quotient in there. By reaching out to serve one or more of those people in some way. So in our scripture today, Colossians 3:17, the Apostle Paul encourages believers with a powerful reminder of that interconnectedness of thankfulness and service. Remember, the verse states, And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The connection between thankfulness and service in this verse is profound. By doing everything in the name of the Lord and giving thanks to God, we are prompted to view our actions as offerings to God. Serving others becomes an expression of gratitude for the grace and blessings received through Christ. It transforms the concept of service from mere duty to a heartfelt response to God's goodness. When we engage in acts of service motivated by a heart of thanksgiving, we embody the teachings of Jesus, who himself came not to be served, but to serve. Service becomes a tangible expression of love for God and for others. It becomes a way to participate in God's work on earth and to reflect his selfless and sacrificial nature. In essence, Colossians 3:17 challenges all of us to integrate thankfulness and service into the fabric of our lives. It suggests that every interaction, every task, every endeavor can be an opportunity to honor God and express gratitude. By living this way, we not only cultivate a deeper connection with God, but also contribute to the well-being and flourishing of the community. You might volunteer at the warming shelter, provide a Thanksgiving meal to someone in need, give to an organization that provides clean water in third world countries, or visit or send a note or card to a homebound senior. Many in our church family have demonstrated their thankfulness and service through donating to the food pantry. There's no shortage of those in need, so continue to put the gratitude you feel for your blessed life into action by serving someone less fortunate. Thank you.
You are strong when you feel weak, never broken. I would like to thank everyone who just testified for what they've given us. And now I have something else to give you. Reminder, Thanksgiving is coming up, and we could use a couple more strong people. Some of us aren't real good at lifting bags anymore. So if any of you have some time and you could help us out, we would really appreciate it. There are two more places to sign up for on the Thanksgiving list. And now I'm going to talk a little bit about the angel tree. The tree is actually going up on the 18th, which is coming up fast, and everything will be available on the 19th out here. There will be computers. There will be people who can help you sign up once you choose the present you would like to give. And I want to tell you a little bit about what is happening this year at Head Start. Both last year and this year, we will have 52 individuals that we will be giving gifts to. Last year, we had 45 kids and 7 families, sometimes a mom or a dad or a whole family that needed some help. This year, we have 51 kids and 1 special need family. So we decided this year to honor the children. Our mission has always been towards them from the beginning. We are hoping that we will be able to share our love and concern for these folks who do have some difficulties functioning in life and greatly appreciate the help that we give them. Today in Growing Connections, it was earlier mentioned that Jenny Dean will be here to talk with us about Head Start. So I hope that you will come and join us and learn about how Head Start was established and what's going on today in Fond du Lac. Thank you.
So once again, the worship team would like to thank everybody who brought items for the food drive. This is going to be donated to the Fondy Food Pantry. And so I ask you to join me as we pray a prayer of blessing over this food drive. If you would like to, as a symbol of your blessing, if you would like to extend your hand forwards to the food items, and we're going to all together join in our thoughts as we pray. Lord God, thank you to each generous individual here who donated items to this food drive. Lord, we know that there are people who are less fortunate than us, and I pray, God, that these items would be a blessing to them, that they would feel the love of God upon them and the love of the community that we support them. I pray for each person who has needs that we could have no clue about, that you would touch them and give them peace and joy and love and comfort in this season. As each person touches this object, may your blessing transfer to them, God. Thank you so much. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
With gratitude for all the blessings you have poured into our lives, Lord Jesus, we come bringing these gifts that they may be used in service to those in need. Bless these gifts and those who have given them, that they may truly be a blessing in your holy name. Amen. You may be seated. And please join me in the prayers of the people. Let us pray for the breaking in of God's kingdom in our world today. Lord God, because Jesus has taught us to trust you in all things, we hold to his word and share his plea. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Where nations budget for war, while Christ says, put up your sword. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Where countries waste food and covet fashion, while Christ says, I was hungry, I was thirsty. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Where powerful governments claim their policies are heaven blessed, while scripture states that God helps the powerless. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Where Christians seek the kingdom in the shape of their own church, as if Christ had come to build and not break barriers. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Where women who speak up for their dignity are treated with scorn or contempt. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Where men try hard to be tough because they're afraid to be tender. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Where we, obsessed with being adult, forget to become like children. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Where our prayers falter, our faith weakens, our light grows dim. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Where Jesus Christ calls us, your kingdom come, your will be done. Lord God, you have declared that your kingdom is among us. Open our ears to hear it, our hands to serve it, our hearts to hold it. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who have sinned against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Wondrous things have done.
for all that God can do within us, for all that God can do without us. Thanks be to God. For all in whom Christ lived before us, for all in whom Christ lives beside us. Thanks be to God. Listen, Christ has promised to be with us in the world as in our worship. Amen. We go to serve him.